Nancy, Stanislas Square, the Triumphant Arch, the Harbour, and the local sweets! Nancy is the new stage of my Tour de France of Tramways! Nancy was the very first city to jump into the venture of the rubber-tyred tramway technology. Since its commissioning in 2001, glitches and criticism have been overwhelming. So, does that technology deserve so many harsh comments? Has the network improved? My review starts now! Just arrived in Nancy. First contact, the tram station. Simple style, but not very welcoming. This electronic display is not very convenient as well, too high and not easy to read. First bad point. The color gray of the tram seems to have been chosen to make the vehicle as discreet as possible. Anyway, it doesn't succeed in hiding its wobbly aspect. I cannot believe I came to Nancy because of the originality of the tramway. Indeed, its rubber-tyred stock uses a central guidance rail when it's operating on a specific track. When it's in service through the city traffic, the tram moves like a high-capacity trolleybus. Actually, it gets complicated when the vehicle has to switch from one mode to another. I'm gonna witness it on a so-called droppage zone. This is the place where the trolleybus becomes a tramway. It quits the autonomous mode to be guided by the central rail. Anyway, it seems the procedure is still not as simple as it was meant to be. 15 years of service and no real improvement. But surprises keep on coming. In order to avoid any derailment, the switch was simply disabled here. And now it's time for me to open a tram. Good surprise! Daily tickets are valid until the end of the next day. Almost 2 days for the price of one? I buy it. I'm on a renovated tram. Time to give some good points. The inboard electronic display? Very efficient. The color raspberry of new seats? Good choice. The fitting out for disabled passengers? Well designed. On the other hand, this technical cabinet is a waste of space. An original design mistake, I guess. When the tramway is on guided mode, I didn't expect such vibrations. The ride becomes noisy and uncomfortable. To discover the reason of those vibrations, I decided to walk along the track. So many patches here. Obviously, rutting is caused by rubber tires passing over and over at the same place. When the tram is operating as a trolleybus, I can see how smooth and silent the ride is. At the terminus, the U-turn track enables the tram to get back online swiftly. I stay there for a while, watching the trolley pole's ballet run by the overhead wires. Great show! So, what is the future of the tramway in Nancy? The current stock is supposed to be running till 2020. However, the project of the second line was given up. Diesel buses with high level of service are already operating on line 2. Too bad, because the former trolleybus network power lines are still visible. As a result of my stay in Nancy, I wouldn't be the first to say that this tramway is a failure. Nancy sacrificed its trolleybus network to jump into the venture of rubber-tyred tramway. The technology wasn't ready enough. The city has been paying the price of it for 15 years. So will the Line 1 be converted into a regular tramway or buses with high level of service? Too soon to say. After almost 20 years of service, the current tramway will join their ancestors to scrap. Those basic vehicles operated in the city for more than 80 years. It is now obvious that the record they set is still open.